Hi everybody, it's Penny. I'm back in my kitchen again. And today I'd like to show you how to make Bakewell slices or mini Bakewells. It's a bit of a family favourite. It's a lovely dessert for after Sunday lunch. It's also nice for an afternoon tea, finger slices. I'm going to do both. I'm going to do a Bakewell tray bake tin, which you can cut into slices. And I'm also going to make some little individual ones. Now, here's your ingredients. I've already made the pastry, baked it blind, and it's all ready to go. Making the pastry is so simple. I didn't think you needed me to demonstrate how to do that. I've actually put a sheet of greaseproof just across my tin. I haven't completely lined it, but it does help you lift the whole thing out later. The pastry's been baked blind. I put little fork prickles in it, and that helps the heat disperse and dry through the pastry. It's been out of the oven a few minutes, obviously, because I can handle the tin. And the little rounds, again, little fork holes, they have been in the oven for 5 minutes just to start them off, because you can't bake these blind, and it just helps to really crisp the pastry up, because there's nothing worse than having a soggy bottom. Right, so first off, I've got my butter in here, nice soft butter. You can use margarine, it works perfectly fine. Into that is going my sugar. I'm just going to give that a quick whiz round. Nice. Something really lovely about watching ingredients combine together and start off as one thing and then metamorphose into something else that you know is going to be yummy. Okay, now into that we're going to put our eggs, which I've already beaten. I'm a bit of a stickler for beating the eggs before I put them in. Silicone spatula. Those of you who've watched my videos before know I'm very fond of my silicone spatulas because they get every last bit out of everything. You're going to go to the effort of making something, you don't want to leave half of it in the bowl, do you? I'm using a stand mixer, but a little electric hand mixer will do this fine. It's not a huge amount of beating and beating. Right, I'm going to beat the eggs in. Just to mix them up. You only need a couple of minutes, beat that, and there we are. And then into that, this has got my flour, baking powder and ground almonds all mixed in together. I'm not going to do any fancy folding or anything, I'm just tipping this in. In it goes. We'll be adding some milk and some almond essence. We'll get the flour going first. Just on low so you don't create clouds. It's a rainy day today. And actually this is a nice thing to do on a rainy day. It's Saturday. So it's also nice to have a dessert already done for Sunday. Well, that'll be nice. There we are. The flour's incorporated. This is never going to be a smooth mixture because you've got ground almonds in it, so it's always going to have a little bit more texture. So in's going my almond essence. This is optional really. I think if you want that almond flavour, you really do need to use the almond essence. And obviously it depends on taste. You can add a little bit more or a little bit less. And then milk's going in here. And then we're going to mix all this together. Simpler. I like to weigh all my ingredients out before I start doing anything. It's a bit of a double check, and you know that you've got everything in and it's all the correct weight and everything. Because if your house is anything like my house, things get a bit busy around here. I've got 4 kids, 13 grandkids, 3 dogs, loads of mates. My sister lives just down the road. 3 of my kids all live within a quarter of a mile of us. So our house is busy. Wouldn't have it any other way, but weighing out your ingredients certainly helps. Okay. Now, before we put that into here, we need the jam. Now, I like seedless raspberry jam because I can't stand the pips. I really don't like the pips. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to give it a bit of a stir in the jar just to loosen it, because it makes it easier to spread. And then on each one of these we're just going to spread a little teaspoon. Not enough on that one. And on this one, a good 2 tablespoons, and a bit more if you fancy. Being generous with the jam adds to the moistness and the deliciousness of this. And my own little tip for something really special, which is, it's optional, you don't have to do it. But is to add to this before you put your mix on. These are frozen raspberries, which I've crushed in the packet with a rolling pin so that they're little bits. And these are going to go on top of here. This gives it that little bit extra. It's a fresh raspberry zing as you bite into it. There we go. That's all that needs to do. And then, wash my hands. Raspberries all over them. There we are. Okay, now we're going to spoon the mixture over this. Just to cover them. Don't have to be fussy. This turns out like more of a spongy. It's not as firm, I think. For those of you who eat Mr Kipling cakes, his cherry Bakewells, the Bakewell mix is a bit firmer than this. This is softer, fluffier and spongier. And personally, although I'm biased, I think it's nicer. Oh, Mr. Kipling. And that is ready to have the sprinkled flaked almonds on, which obviously is your traditional topping on a Bakewell. It's going to go in the oven I'm generous with my almond flakes. You're going to make something. Do it properly. Don't be stingy. He's going in the oven along with these, and I'll see you when they're cooked. Hi guys, they're out of the oven and cooled. I've cut them up, tray bake, and the individual minis. Now, the recipe I gave you, the quantities are for one or other of these. I've made a double quantity because I've done the tray bake and the 12 minis. But the recipe quantities that you've got will do either the tray bake or the 12 minis. Obviously, you just double it up if you want to make both. I don't know if you can see this, but can you see how light and fluffy and how beautiful the raspberry is? The pastry is crisp, the sponge is fluffy, and the almonds on the top are toasty. They smell divine, they look great. The little individual ones are perfect for an afternoon tea. And I normally put them in muffin cases, the muffin wraps, but I ran out of them, so I've just popped them in just inside individual little cupcake cases, just for ease of handling really. It smells wonderful. I'm going to eat one now with a nice cup of tea. If you've got a particular recipe of something that you fancy and you're not sure how to do it, why don't you message us at Gower New Life Church, just put recipe, and we'll see what we can do, and we could do a video just for you. These, by the way, have cooked for 25 to 30 minutes for the tray bake and 18 to 20 minutes for the individuals. It is all on the recipe sheet that I put up at the first, on the first shot, all the methods on there and the timings. Enjoy. We enjoy. See you again. I'm Penny. Bye.